Good to see Josh and Shan back in the house. Woo! I miss my family when y'all go home. Listen, this message is for real Christians. All right? I'm going to tell you this. If you heed the word of the Lord in this, amen, you will be able to command mountains and they will move for you. Amen? All right? God is restoring this real church. Amen. And so it did something to me to hear the message from Pastor Jeremy last week, because it brought out even more boldness. Amen. We do not serve a God who does not hear our cries. Are you hearing me? We do not serve a God who is weak, whose arm is short, who cannot move any mountain that's in this world. Are you hearing me? Look at your neighbor and say, fear not.
Fear not.
For the Lord is with us.
For the Lord is with us.
Satori Amanakata. Fear not, for he is with us. I want you to pay attention to this word, because many of us have read this, but it doesn't really hit us. And it goes as following. That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, and this is Paul speaking, the Father of glory may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, that the eyes of your understanding be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling. Look at your neighbor and say, the hope of his calling. And what are the true riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. Look at your neighbor and say, you got an inheritance that came from God. He wants you to know the true riches that he gave you. And what is the exceedingly greatness of his power towards us who believe, according to the works of his mighty power, which he worked in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in heavenly places. Now, I want you to pay attention to this. Far above principalities. All principalities. Look at your neighbor and say, far above all principalities.
Far above all principalities.
Far above all power.
Far above all power.
Far above all might.
Far above all might.
Far above all dominion.
Far above all dominion.
And
every name.
Every name. That is named.
That is named.
That includes the name of cancer. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Amen.
And he put all things under his feet and gave him to be head over all things to the church. Did you hear that?
Yes.
Look at your neighbor and say, he gave it to you.
He gave it to you.
Which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. You may be seated. How many of y'all got a real job? Anybody heard the term? A real job. If you're a teenager and you first got a job, you know when you first got a real job. What did you say? Man, I got a real job. You know what the real job? Why did you call it a real job? Most of the time? Because it comes with benefits. Anybody ever went to interviews and say, man, they got insurance, they got this, they got, they give you a book of so much stuff, here's your benefits. Don't it feel good? Can I tell you something? You got some spiritual benefits I've been ready to tell you about. Listen, God is tired of his people thinking that they're the underdogs. Are you hearing me? Look at your neighbor and say, you have a positional advantage above the world. You have an inherited advantage. Listen, no longer think that you're behind the eight ball because you're a Christian. Are you hearing me? God's word is true. We're gonna find out that we have to believe that God's word is true. Amen?
Amen.
Are y'all with me?
Yes.
And so I wanted to try to correct some of the things that we've been taught as a religious. I'm trying not to talk about people. But I come from a very religious background when I was a child. Amen?
Amen.
I'm talking about your skirts had to be down to your ankles. See, y'all millennials, y'all new generation, y'all avoided a lot of stuff. Are you hearing me? Our pain became your pleasure. Are you hearing me? You didn't have to experience all the manipulation and the control and the, you gotta eat TV dinners in order to be right with Christ. If you go to the movies, you're sitting in the seat of the scornful. That's what they used to tell us. You couldn't go to the show. Are you hearing me? If you did, it was a sin. Amen? But I'm here to tell you, can I tell you some truth? As Christians, they teach you about the victory that Christ won over the cross, right?
Yeah.
And some say they tell you to ride on that victory. Christ did it all for you, right? And everything else is fixed. Can I tell you, that's not just it. That's just the beginning of it. Amen? You mean you say, I got more to do? It has all to do with your understanding of what Christ did for you. Are you hearing me? Pay attention to me when I say this. If you don't know what Christ has really done for you, you will miss out on some stuff. Are you hearing me? You will miss the mark. And it's okay in a regular church because you're just going to be sitting there giving your money away anyway. But if you come with the prophetic and you come with demons, you will get eaten alive if you don't know what Christ really did for us. Are you hearing me? See, the dominion and the victory for a believer, it does not depend on what just the victory of Christ. It depends on your understanding. Look at your neighbor and say, it depends on your understanding. I assure you, if I asked everybody in here about your understanding, it'll be a different answer. What is your understanding of what God did for you? It wasn't just him going to the cross so you could make it to heaven. It was a transference of power. Anybody get that book, Ordinary People, Extraordinary Power? By John Eckhart. I've said that before. That's a powerful book. It's so true. God took ordinary people and he put his extraordinary power on us.
Amen.
Do you know that?
Yes.
Amen? So look at your neighbor and say, fear not.
Fear not.
The Lord is with you.
The Lord is with you.
And I know you may have come in the name of Jesus. You may have come in the name of the knowledge of Jesus. And tried to cast a demon out and tried to move a mountain. And maybe nothing happened. But it's something that happens when you come with the knowing of your office in Jesus.
Mm.
Yeah, you getting that?
Yes.
I'll give you an example. When I gave God my title, what I wanted to be for him. Amen?
Mm.
So, my brother says, man, I think he said he had a dream or something. He said, I had a dream that you was an apostle. Of course, man, that's my brother. That's my brother. You see, that calling stuff was for Dion only. That prophet stuff is. And the truth of the matter is, I was scared about being an apostle. That's the truth of the matter. You know, I was scared to speak a word to somebody. You know why? Because my image was in the way. What if I would have got it wrong? Are you hearing me? Any prophet will tell you, anybody tell you. What if I would have got it wrong? But you have to be so sure of yourself in Christ. This is why God has to get rejection out of you. Are you hearing me? This is why God told the prophets, do not look at their faces. Because somebody's face will jack you up, won't it? You begin to give them a word and they look at you like this. If you don't know that you are hearing from God, you will go into error and you will start trying to guess. Are you hearing me? And this is not even a mess. I don't know why I'm saying this, but I know it's the Spirit of God. Listen to me here as I say this. Because God has given each one of us an executive office in the kingdom of God. Amen?
Amen.
And if you heed these words, if you hear this, let me tell you something. Anybody that has military power behind them, they have a crew that's behind them. Are you hearing me? God doesn't just assign you his power. He assigns you his angels to go along with it. Are you hearing me? And I want you to know each one of that is different. So as we go into the prophetic, don't feel discouraged if you try to cast out a demon or you're praying for somebody and then you see an apostle or prophet come over and, oh, man, it came out for them. Look at your neighbor and say, there's a ranking in the spirit.
Ranking in the spirit.
Just like the military, there's a ranking. Did you think a soldier, a foot soldier can go to somebody and say, hey, go do this? Are you hearing me? It's the same in the spirit. God gives you a ranking in the spirit. Now, some of y'all, y'all ain't got past boot camp yet. Y'all still trying to, you haven't even got your uniform yet. And you're trying to cast demons out of people. But in the spirit, there's a ranking that God places in you. And so never look at nobody's office and say that's easy. Are you hearing me? Spiritually, if I lift this podium up, you see me do it with my two hands, but you can rest assured there's 20 people in the spirit that's doing that with me. So it may look easy to you as I lift this. Are you catching that?
Yes, that's really good.
You say, man, what is this man? He can lift that very, but then I have a ranking that's behind me. Are you hearing me? And let me tell you how that works. See, when the enemy comes at you and he says, I'm going to get him. I'm going to do this right here. Listen, do you know how there's a spiritual circle? There's a crew that's behind you that protects you. All right? We're not just talking about your guardian angel. Everybody's talking about you. And let me tell you, the more you tune in to God, the more you know him, the more ranking you go up. You go up ranks. This is why it's very imperative that you pass these tests that God has given you. He's allowing. He's not giving it to you. He's allowing it in your life. Are you hearing me? Many of you probably would not even know the test me and prophet that's gone through in the last couple of months. I'm talking about people. I mean, you name it. All right? It's out the blue. Many people. All right? Many people. All right? And the enemy wants us to focus on the people and not the purpose. Are you hearing me? Y'all better catch that. But I'm here to tell you, I passed the test.
Amen.
And with that, God added some more ranking to me. Y'all better catch that. He added some more backing to me. You see, people have the ideal that because you prophesied that to them and say, if you do this, this is going to happen, they think they can turn around and say the same thing to you. But why? By what dominion do you have the power to say that? You say, well, I could prophesy to you and say, this is going to happen to you too. But your words don't carry any power because I have a crew behind me that when I speak, when I speak, my crew begins to move.
Yeah. That's so good.
If I said it through God, the words would be upheld through my spiritual backing. If you said it through your own spirit, it shall fall to the ground.
Yes.
Y'all better catch that. Am I right, prophet? People have the nerve to turn around and say, well, I can prophesy to you too and say, well, this is going. I see the church breaking in half. I see the pride on the leaders. Are you hearing me? Y'all better catch. The only thing that broke apart was you from this ministry. Yeah, better catch that. The Bible says an unfair curse will not fall on his intended victim. You can speak all you want to. I have a crew behind me. Y'all look at y'all niggas. They got a crew behind me. Soto Rema Nakata. I'm going to tell you, be very careful with a man of God. Are you hearing me? Because the truth is in the matter is, even if the man of God is in the wrong, God will still back him. Y'all better catch that. Oh, my God. You want proof? You want proof? Abraham's walking through and say, hey, lie and say you my sister because I don't want them to kill me. Lie, because she was beautiful. And back then, they'll kill you for your wife. Says lie. The king gets happy and says, woo, that's a sister. Okay, I'm gonna marry her. I'm gonna get down. Sarah. God sends him a dream and says, if you do this, you will be cursed. The king says, call him. Why would you lie to me and tell me? Listen, he lied to me. And God says, listen, go to Abraham and pray that he and have him pray the curse off of your life.
Jesus.
But he lied to me.
Right.
Y'all better catch this. Because God backs this man of God. Are you hearing me? Do you know there's a carnal conscience that limits your dominion in the spirit? Some of you, don't take offense if God says you have a carnal mind. Okay? People, carnal mind? Let me tell you what a carnal mind is. You reference this world for your acceptance. Everything around the world. And so you try to mix it with God, and you think it's God's trying to tell you something, but you're using the circumstances around you for your answer. That's a carnal mind. You use the fleshly things of the world to get your answer. God, what are you trying to say? Are you hearing me? And Lord, let me tell you all the prophets and the apostles and the bishops that's coming forth, right? Because the Bible tells you it's very simple. You should know them by their what?
Fruit.
Right? You have to move self out the way before you can prophesy. Did you notice most prophets on the internet, if you notice, they always try to tell you they had a dream. They try to have it. It's always a safe mechanism where if they get it wrong, you really can't say you got it wrong. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Let me give you an example. Jeremy, I see you've been through some stuff. I see you've been through a lot of things in your life. Well, you can hand that to LaKay. LaKay can hand that to Patriot. That prophecy goes to everybody, right? In fact, you're going to fill in the blanks. God must be talking about that. Are you hearing me? That's a safe prophecy. You can't say it's wrong. You can't say it was. Are you hearing me? I was talking to Pastor Jeremy, matter of fact, last Sunday, and said, the truth of the matter is, God doesn't give you boldness in every area. As bold as Pastor Jeremy is, and what you call him, guess what? He had to struggle when it comes to the prophecy area. It's like, oh boy. It's because God gives you another. Now, God gave us the boldness in the prophecy land. I need the boldness in the walking up to people. Are you hearing me? You see how God balances? So I needed that. I need to be able to have that balance to be able to walk up to somebody. Because there has been times where I've seen somebody in a crippled state, and I'd be like, man, God, I wish they would walk up. I wish they could come out of that chair. Are you hearing me? Look at your neighbor and say, God will give you the way.
God will give you the way.
Lord have mercy. Are y'all getting something out of this?
Yes, so good.
A carnal conscious mind will limit your dominion and your power God has given you.
Mm.
A spiritual conscious mind actually removes all limits from God. Are you hearing me? Have you ever limited God in your life?
Yep.
You only think he can do a certain thing. Are you hearing me?
Mm-hmm.
That's called a carnal mind. What I can think about is the only thing I can think about. As high as I can think, as high as I think God can move in my life. But the Bible tells you, as high as the heavens are above the earth, so are my ways above your ways and my thoughts above your thoughts. As the rain cometh down from the earth and the snow, so it shall be with my word. When I send it out, it shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish that. What? Oh yeah. We got anybody here to read the Bible?
Yes.
Look at your neighbor and say, it's impossible for God to lie.
It's impossible for God to lie.
Now let me give you some good news. I want you to say to your neighbor, I am seated with Christ,
I am seated with Christ.
Above all dominions,
above all kingdoms,
above all authorities. Is that not the word?
Yes.
Therefore, you are above
and not beneath.
And you're not beneath. Are you hearing me? Did he say every name? See, the importance of a name tells you. This is why it's not good to claim things on you. All right? I cringe when people say, Yeah, my diabetes. Did you go to the store and buy that off the shelf? My HDA, I had an inspector at the house, yeah. Yeah, that's my HDA, what do they call it? ADH, that's my HDA. My? Oh, Jesus. Look at your name and say, did you go to Walmart and buy that? Paul is praying in this scripture. He's saying, I pray that God gives you the spirit of wisdom and opens your, enlightens your heart to the understanding of this, that he gave you some riches. Yes. I better catch that. Not only did he die for you, but he gave you some inheritance riches that says you are now in the place with me. Not only did I die for you, but I brought you up to sit right next to me with all power. And so therefore, Jesus' possibilities becomes my possibilities. Y'all better catch that. Oh my God. Let me tell you the danger in this. Because if you don't catch this, the Bible said a man of honor who knoweth not will die in the field like a beast. Are you hearing me? Do you get that? A man of honor, a man that has been honored, a man that is exalted, a man, but he don't know it. He would die in the field like a beast. He would die like a common person. Yet, I've given him authority. Are you hearing that? A man that God has given authority to, but yet he does not know it. He does not operate in it. He does not know that I have exalted him. When Jesus Christ died. Now you hear me? Yes. Y'all better catch this.
Ooh, that's good.
Oh, boy. A man that has been given the same dominion as Christ and don't know it will die in the field like a beast. You know what the Bible... In other words, God has given us dominion. In other words, you would die in the hand like people. God has given us dominion over animals. You'll die at the enemy's hands just like an animal. Mm. You'll lose. Are you catching this? Are you getting this?
Yes.
You see, some of us are waiting for our bank accounts to line up so we can say we're with Christ. We're waiting for our bank accounts to line up. Then we'll say, God, yeah, you are with me. We're waiting for that promise. We're waiting for that husband, that wife. Then you'll say, God, yeah, you are. Can I tell you that scripture says, if you wait for money, if you're waiting for these things to happen to you, you're going to lose out on some stuff. Are you hearing me? Are you waiting for the affirmation of men to tell you God is with you? You better know it already. Somebody say, I'm exalted.
I'm exalted.
You see, religious people will tell you that's pride. There's no pride in speaking of what God has done for you. Speaking of the authority that God has placed you in. Are you hearing me? Lord Jesus. As a matter of fact, what is that scripture? Thank you, Father. Jeremiah, I want to say, is around the 23rd verse. Let me remember it. It says, some of it's going to be paraphrasing. It says, thus says the Lord, let not a wise man take glory in wisdom. Let not a man of strength or might take glory in being mighty.
Jeremiah 9:23.
9:23-24. Go ahead and read it.
It says, thus says the Lord, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom. Let not the mighty man glory in his might. Nor let the rich man glory in his riches. But Let him who glories glory in this, that he understands and knows me, that I am the Lord, exercising loving kindness, judgment, and righteousness in the earth. For I delight in these things.
That's it. He says, listen, take no honor that you are wealthy. Take no honor that you... Did you hear what that just said? He says, but glory in this, that you know me and you understand me. Those are two things there God gave you. See, Christian churches have just said, I know Christ. And that's the first thing you say, oh, I know Christ. But do you understand him? God says that you understand my ways. Are you hearing me? This is where we go wrong in the church. We don't understand God's. We don't understand the authority God has given us. Are you here? And therefore, you have been exalted. You have been, look at your name and say, you've been honored by God. But yet you would die in the field like a beast because you do not know this. You don't know the power you carry. Look at your name and say, you don't know the power you carry. You are seated above. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
Y'all getting this?
Yes.
All right. Y'all better catch this. Because every believer that has this understanding, are you hearing me? You will not pray for money anymore. You will not pray for the situation anymore. Are you hearing me? You would say, Satan, you've been over my finances enough. I came to you before in the knowing of Christ, but this time I come to you in the knowing of the power that God gave me, in the office that he's gave me. Are you hearing me? It's something about Satan. Listen, he does not know. He does not like when you know who you are. Oh, my God.
No, we don't.
He does not like when you know. So somebody, oh, that's pride. You, no, it's not pride. I come to you with a backing behind me, Satan.
Yes.
This time I came by myself and just know. But this time I come with my military crew that God has assigned to me. Y'all better go. Saturimi makata. You've oppressed my family enough. Are you hearing me? You've hit my finances enough.
Yes.
This time I come with the power of heaven because I am seated above.
Yes.
Look at your name and say, you have an inherent advantage. You have a shared dominion. You don't have absolute dominion, but you have a shared dominion with Christ. Therefore, if he reigns, you reign.
That's right.
Oh, my God. It's time out for you seeing God as a weak God who can't save you. Oh, my God.
Wow.
I think I just got to. Listen, if you ever say, I just got to accept this situation, you are insulting your maker.
Yes.
Oh, my God. This is not a privilege that was just given for preachers. Look at it. Look your name and say, it's for everybody.
It's for everybody.
And Acts Peter says, I perceive the truth that God is no respecter of person.
That's right.
Are you hearing me?
That's right.
You know how we think? You know what? God chose them because they're handsome twins. 6'2". That's why God chose them. They identical twins. I bet you that's why he put a double anointing on them. Isn't that the way we think? God did not choose apostles and prophets because we're twins. Are you hearing me? He assigned me a rank. Look at your neighbor and say, do you know your rank?
Do you know your rank?
Do you know your rank in the spirit?
Do you know your rank in the spirit?
Are you hearing me? Anybody remember the guy that spoke in fluent Jamaican that came up in here at one point in time? Yeah. Listen, it was hilarious, but it was, let me tell you. The guy was talking English, so let me tell you, the demon in him talked fluent Jamaican. When I tell you, you could not even tell the accent. When I tell you, because he came one Sunday, he's talking like this, the next Sunday, he's, yeah, man. He said he found his ancestral background and God gave him the tongue. But when I tell you his testimony was, Listen, I fight demons as big as giant as buildings. Ooh. He said, I see them in the spirit realm. Mm. And you know what he said about us? He said, wow, you guys are giant in the spirit realm. Mm. I saw, I can see. Listen, when you lay hands on me, I saw how big you were in the spirit. Oh yeah, y'all better kiss that.
Wow.
And so when I tell a demon to be still, it's not him, just the, there is a backing that surrounds him and say, be stable. Mm. Don't move.
Yes.
Oh my God.
That's good.
Oh my God. It's called the far above mentality. I am far above. Mm. What does a person on an airplane have to do with a mountain? But as a matter of fact, if you're flying in an airplane, you don't even know when you went over a mountain. Mm. Are you hearing me? Mm-hmm. Therefore, that tells me your perspective of a mountain depends on the field you're in.
Y'all better catch that. Wow.
Y'all better catch that. But God says, I've never put you in this field. I told you were far above. Mm. Oh, my God. Oh my goodness, y'all better catch this. Are y'all ready to go home? Look at your neighbor and say, you have an inherited advantage. You have a spiritual ranking. His possibilities are now my possibilities. Let me tell you something. Do you think God is sitting at home sick? Do you think Jesus is sitting?
No.
Do you think Jesus says, God, can you let me have... Let me tell you something. We're praying all wrong. You keep praying to God for stuff, and God says, I already gave you the authority to command it to come to you.
Jesus.
Many of us have spiritual warriors waiting on their command, and they have axe in hand, and they're just standing there because you won't command them.
Mm. Oh, Jesus.
They're sitting there waiting for the word, but they have no leader. Look at your name and say, you've been seated in heavenly places. Above all dominions. Above all powers. Above all names. And so whatever name you can name, are you hearing me?
Yes.
Diabetes, I'm seated above. Cancer, I'm seated above.
Yes.
Oh my God, y'all better.
Yes.
Lord Jesus. Are y'all getting something out of this?
Yes.
What you consider as an unmovable mountain shows me the realm that you think in. Mm. It shows me that you think carnally. You think on the realm that's everything is a mountain. Everything, oh my, now I gotta climb this, now I climb that. God says go above it.
Mm. That's good.
Oh my God. Let me tell you something. There's no mountain in this world that has ever stopped me. None. I don't care what it looked like. I went above it. So what you're saying, God? We call ourselves kings and queens in God, right? Let me tell you our mentality, though. We think we're only a king or a queen if we're sitting in the palace, right? If I got the palace to match it, then I'll call myself a king. All right, but in the spirit realm, wherever the king at, it is. Are you hearing? Wherever the queen is, becomes the palace. You see, a king doesn't let the building influence who he is. He influences the building. Wow. Y'all better catch that.
Yes.
In other words, wherever I'm at, if I'm in a room right now, I already know I'm seated above. It's just a matter of time before I come up out of here. Are you hearing me? You see, I influence the room. The room doesn't influence me. Amen. When you're carnal-minded, the room influences you. Yes. Oh, my God. Y'all better catch that. Mm. What's happening around you influences you. You don't feel like a king anymore, a queen. I don't know about this thing. In fact, many of you, God, the enemy gets you to question. Why? It make you feel like a fool if you're honest with yourself for even believing God. Why not even believe that? Are y'all getting something out of this?
Yes.
John 3:31 says, he that cometh from above is above all things. Mm. He that comes from the earth is earthly. Now you hear me. He that comes from the west is a western. He that comes from America is America. But it says, he that cometh from heaven is above all. Look at your neighbor and say, he's above all. This is what the Bible says. He who is carnal-minded will receive death. But he who is spiritual-minded will receive what?
Life.
And it says, and peace. Mm-hmm. If your mind is carnal-minded, you get nothing but death. Mm-hmm. Are you hearing me? Destruction. Oh, Lord. Because your convictions are based on this realm of what you feel. Not by what God said. He said you're seated above. Did God not say I'd given Jesus all power? All authority? Did he say that?
Mm, yes.
Are you hearing me? Let me show you. So you check your bank account and you only got $19.87 in there. Not even 20. Are you hearing me? You have no car. You've been waiting for that relationship. And so you begin to describe yourself based on what you see. That's called carnal mind. You describe yourself based on what you feel, based off of what you saw in your account. Are you getting that? Lord Jesus. Let me tell you the danger too, because a carnal minded, a religious mind and a carnal mind would tell you, oh, he's being prideful. See, that's being prideful. Let me tell you what let me put it this way. I'm not trying to offend nobody. Let me tell you, in most relationships, if you catch this, what God says, listen, don't take honor in all of the money. Don't take honor in that you're strong. Don't take honor in that you're rich. But he who glorifies, glorify in this, that you know me, that you know me and you know my ways, you understand me. Can I tell you, that is most marriages, that's where the problem comes at. A wife would say, my husband says he knows me, but he does not what? Does not understand me. Women, can I get a? He does not understand me. Okay, be quiet. The husband is saying, I know you, but the wife is saying, he does not understand me. Understanding is an intimate part of, are you hearing me? In other words, I know how you operate. And therefore, when this comes against me, I already know my God is already against it. I don't have to pray to him. Are you hearing me? Y'all better catch that. Let me tell you another thing where we go wrong at in marriages, all right? Yeah, we already know God made the man the head. We already know that, all right? You're not going to go into that. But did you know God gave a shared authority even to the woman, all right? He gave a shared authority. You know what authority he gave? Something that a man can't touch. And it's kind of amazing. He says the man is the head, but then he says, I've given the power. Read the Bible. Only in the Bible I'll see that he says, I've given the power to the woman to build her house or tear it down. Mm-hmm. The woman doesn't look at that. That's greater than being the head right there. You can destroy your entire house or you can build it up. But you're too busy looking at the authority of your husband saying, I'm trying to make sure he's not being prideful. You didn't have to say it like
Jesus.
I know you're the head, but you ain't have to say it like.
Yes.
See, you being prideful now. Is it your job to correct pride in me?
No.
No, I am walking in the office that God had. And if you happily walk in yours, we'll have some peace in this house. Are you hearing me? Oh, my God. But you're considering me. You're saying I'm disturbing the peace, but God, the Bible tells you I gave you the authority to keep the peace in your house or to tear it down. You pointing at him saying, it's your fault. Who you think God's going to hold accountable? He says, I gave you the power to either build your house up, woman. But see, but you're looking at this and you're saying it's tearing it down, and so therefore you're tearing it down. You're saying the situation is, but it's you that's actually tearing your own house down. Oh my God. Y'all better catch that. I'm gonna talk to you about a secular authority just a little bit. How everybody feel about secular? I'm not gonna even go to the police. No, that's a rough subject right there. Look, God wants you to respect secular authority. Did you know that?
Yep.
All right. You don't have to like their ways. You don't have to. See, we have the idea as a Christian that I will respect you and I'll do what you say as long as I agree with what you're doing. That's not authority. Are you hearing me? That's not authority. As long as I get something out of it, then I'll do what the husband says. Are you hearing me? Oh my God. Some of y'all saying, I was ready for marriage, and I guess I'm not now. That includes the laws that are written for our safety. Do you know God authorized the laws? The speed limit is there, not just for you to break. This is what, let me tell you something. When you have a carnal mind, you think it's okay to wake up late and rush to work. You do this every single day. You know it takes you 30 minutes to get to your job. You wake up, you set your clock for an hour. Then you hit snooze for 15 minutes. You get a 45 minutes, and then you speed through the stop sign, speed through the lights. You say, oh, I made it here.
Jesus.
Let me tell you, it gets worse. You know it takes you 30 minutes to get to church. You wake up, you set your clock for 45 minutes early and hit snooze. And then you break 6 stoplights to get to church on time and say, I'm worshiping you, God. Oh, my God. Do you know God expects you to govern your life to spec? See, it never hits a person to let me get up early so I can get to work on time without breaking the law. Oh, my God. Why does it never hit you to say, I could set my alarm clock for 2 hours early? Well, you know, I'd be tired. Go to sleep. You watching TV at 2 o'clock in the morning.
Wow.
Nothing tells you to cut off 2 hours of TV so you can get some sleep. So I don't have to. Do you know how many people lose their lives every day breaking laws?
Wow.
Mm-hmm. Just hitting the gas, go right through that stop sign, boom. Get to heaven. God is looking at you. But God, I was on my way to work. Yeah, let me fast forward your life back. You begin to be late right here. You begin to be late right here. Why didn't you never, if you would have just took your clock, just think about that. You're in heaven right now. God says, if you would have just fast, rewind your clock 1 hour and went to sleep earlier, you would still be on earth. Oh my God. Y'all looking at me mad now. You ready to protect me, woman of God?
No, I will.
Oh my God. I'm not scared of y'all. I got a backing behind me. I got a military force behind me.
Got that crew.
Got the crew. Are you hearing me? Let me give you a backdrop. Did you know back in the Old Testament, when they found people who were demonized, you know, it was two ways they handled it. They stoned them to death. That was the number one. They couldn't handle it. They couldn't handle people who were demonized. So they saw it as uncurable, and they would stone them to death. Are you hearing me? The second one is called occulted pacifism. You know what pacifism is? It's actually the art of saying we don't want to go to war, we don't want to fight. We'll make having to fight the last thing we do. And I only will fight if you attack me. Then I'm morally just if I kill you if you attacked me first. Let me show you something. The authority. You see, they didn't have any authority. Jesus shows up on scene and he's the only one that surgically removes the influence from the individual. Are you hearing me? With a word, he says, separate yourself from them. So you look at that. Look at what they're doing here. Because they say Jesus. No, you're not fooling us. You're not doing that by God. What you have done is you're doing this. You're doing this by Bezel. You're doing this by the prince of demons. Are you hearing me? Well, you know what they're telling Jesus? No, I know what happened. You worked your way up in the spirit realm. You found a way to get the power from this demon. That's why you're casting out. Are you hearing me? This is what they're saying. Because this was the practice of them, is to negotiate with demons. So what happened was they would conjure up the demons. The occulted pacifism, they would conjure up the demon, and they would say, why are you bothering this person? What do you want? Then they would offer the demon, okay, what do you want? We'll get what you want if you leave that person alone. And the demon would say, go get a black goat. Go get this, and I want you to sacrifice it to me. And it sounds like you're placing yourself in the place of God. And it began to get worse and worse. This is how they begin to start sacrificing babies. They start sacrificing. Because the demons saw themselves as gods. Are you hearing me? Are you getting that? So Jesus shows up on scene, and they cannot understand the authority. That's why you hear, when Jesus says, if I'm casting it out by the prince of demons, then in whom your sons are casting them out by? Now that sounds like, okay, Jesus, you gave a smart comment. That was good. He wasn't saying that because he was trying to be smart. He was saying that because they were making deals with demons. And then he says, if you know that I cast them out by them, he says, no. But if you know that I cast out the demons by the finger of God, you'll know the kingdom of God. In other words, you'll know the authority of God has come upon you. You better catch that. Lord Jesus. Look at your neighbor and say, you have a ranking in the spirit. Do you know what it is? Let me tell you the importance of knowing your ranking. This is why you see people. If you do not have the ranking to heal somebody, if your crew doesn't say you got an angel behind you, or you have a crew that God gave you for healing, you can call as many people as you want to, and nothing gonna happen. You're saying, "Well, but Sarah laid hands on and got healed," because she has a ranking behind her. God has anointed her and gave her the force behind that to back it up. Are you hearing me? Y'all better catch that. Demons don't go by your personality. They don't go by your family history. They don't, listen, they are called strongholds. They only know ranking. That's it. Are you hearing me? And the first thing they do when they come for us is they see, do you know who you really are? And do you know the power that God gave you? And most of the time the answer is no. I don't even know the power God's given. I don't know that I have an equal authority. I have a shared dominion with Christ. That if Christ says you have to come out, I can say that I have the same authority. Are you hearing me? Christ is the only one that comes. And they say he teaches like a man of what? Because Christ is teaching. Not just, now you got to understand, there were some cold-blooded prophets that they have seen. Now, the words came to truth. They prophesied and everything. But they said, this man is different. He speaks as a man who comes with authority, and then he backs it up afterwards. You better catch that. And so the Pharisees would ask him, oh, now who gave you the authority? I am the authority. Y'all better catch that. And so sometimes when you see demons, you may see me cast out 10 demons. You may see the prophet come over and says, there's another one sitting there. Why? Because he has a different ranking than I have. Are you hearing me? God gave me access to the 10 demons that my crew got rid of. Then that's why it's important to have, to know your access. Because you'll have people say, hey, go get everybody and bring them to heal them. We're going to heal them. I'll bring all the sick, bring all the, that's faith. But if you don't have the ranking behind you, it will never happen. Are you hearing me? Y'all better catch that. Are y'all getting something out of this? Are y'all ready to go?
Yes.
Jesus shows up as a model of the church and says, this is what my church is supposed to be doing. Are you hearing me? He surgically removes. He's the only one that can remove the influence from the individual. You know our demons are just influencers. Y'all thought that was a new word. Demons are influencers. They influence you to do what? Evil. They're just influencers. See, that's a powerful word. Oh man, he's an influencer. Demons been doing this for a long time. That's not a new word. Demonic spirits are influencers. Oh Lord Jesus. They say, no, you're doing this by the power of Beelzebub. That's why I know you done worked your way up in the spirit realm, because they would negotiate with demons and that's how they would get things done. So they said, no, you just found another way. Now, we dealing with the lower spirits, but you found the way to get to the king. That's why you're able to do this. Y'all better catch that. That's why they was not able to understand the authority that Christ came in. Look at your name and say, you're seated above. And so most Christians don't realize the power that God granted them when Jesus died. Let me tell you this. I think I was telling Pastor Jeremy and Sarah this. Did you know the last thing that Christ dealt with on the cross before he died was guilt and shame? And the very last thing was rejection. Because of the sins of us that was on Jesus, you hear Jesus say, God, Father, why have you forsaken me? God could not look at him any further. So God turned his back, and Jesus felt the actual sign of rejection, because I could not look at the sins no further. So God turned his back on him. That was the sins that came from you. Yeah? That is powerful. If you really realize that, you'll never let guilt and shame come on you again. You'll never let rejection come on you, because Jesus already paid the price. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
You've got to clap. Yes. That was a real thing when he says, Father, why have you forsaken? I don't see you no more. Oh my God. Some of y'all saying that very thing right now. God, why have you forsaken? Let me tell you the primary way to execute your authority in Christ. It's not just physical action. It starts with words. Let me tell you.
Yes, it does.
It starts with words. Jesus was the what? The word. This is why Satan always uses your mouth to curse yourself. If it ain't one thing after another, you are prophesying to yourself. I take two steps forward and I get knocked. Two steps. You are prophesying to your destiny. If God has given us the authority to cast out demons with words, you can best believe he gave you the authority to form your world with words. Oh my God. And if Satan can change your life from the spirit realm, you better believe this is where you should be activating in the spirit realm. Are you hearing me? Can I tell you a secret? Most Christians pray all wrong. Can I tell you that? A little custom. You know what the church has taught us? To pray. You really only earnestly pray if you're honest with yourself when something happens. And I tell you, in the spirit realm, you're already too late. Today's prayer should have been prayed a long time ago. Y'all better catch this. Today's prayer needs to be already here in the spirit realm when it comes, so it can stop anything that happens that's not of God's will. Oh my God. Y'all better catch that. Listen, God giving y'all some nuggets today. The Bible says he upholds all things by the word of his power. Not the power of his word, the word of his power. That's a difference. That means the word itself is power. Oh my God. Oh Lord Jesus. So, you know what another thing with church have lied to people about? And most people think that God hears everybody's prayers. Can I be honest with you? He doesn't. How do you know, Apostle? The Bible tells you Hagar cried out and God didn't hear her, but the Bible says, the angel showed up and says, "Fear not, I heard the lad's cry." What do you want? Let me tell you what happened. Okay, so you know the story, right? Y'all know who Hagar is?
Yeah.
Right? God tells her, Abraham, that's called Abraham's mistake, what y'all try to do. Mm-hmm. That's called your trying to help God mistake. Mm-hmm. It can't come to, well, God just said it can't come to truth, so I'm going to help him out. I can't fathom in my mind how that's going to happen at 90 with Sarah. So I know what God's talking about. Just bring your servant and I'll have. We're going to help God out. Anybody?
Yep, we do this.
And so it causes, listen, that was, if you look at it, that was a, trying to help God out would cause him the most pain in his life. Did you see that? But yet God says, since this is your seed, he tells Abraham, he says, do what your wife has said and send them away. Well, I'm going to make you a promise. Since he's still your seed, I'm going to exalt him as well. Even in your mistake, I'm still going to raise. Y'all better catch that.
Right.
And so they leave, and all Abraham gives them is a bottle and a flask of water. The Bible tells you that water ran out. Let me tell you why Hagar was crying out. She lays the boy under the tree and says, "Let me get away from him. I don't want to see him die." Look at your neighbor and say, selfishness.
Selfishness.
So her cry was based on selfish motives. I don't want to see. But you know what the son's cry was on, based off of? Because his mother was crying. Y'all better catch that. He did not want to see. It's something about a heartfelt cry that God cannot ignore. Are you hearing me? And the Bible says, fear not. He sends an angel. Fear not. I heard the lad's cry. What do you want? Oh my God, y'all better catch that.
Wow.
I heard the heartfelt cry. See, we only cry out to God heartfelt when something happens. Do you know you're supposed to cry? You're supposed to send prayers way before even. Listen, we think that the prayers are for stopping something badder from happening. Do you know the prayers is to stop it from happening, period. Do you know you can form your words, you can sit, listen. Every tongue that rises up against me shall be cast down. It shall be in judgment. I send the words out now. Y'all better catch this. Oh, God. Are y'all getting something out of this?
Yes, Lord.
We have been trained to only pray earnestly in the face of danger. That's the only time you will see anything that comes out of us. Most of the time, it's selfish prayer. It's to prevent further damage. Oh my God. Do you look at your name and say, God has given you authority to command your world. Tomorrow's prayer should have been prayed a week ago. If you pray when the results get here, you're already too late. Oh my God. You've already too late. I don't want to hear what I'm saying in this place. And so God's going to give you a challenge for the next 30 days. Do not ask God for a thing. Command it with the authority he has given you. Are you hearing me? God told me to stop praying for money, son. I've already placed that on your life. Listen, speak to money and command it to come to you. Oh my God. The worst thing is a man that has been honored and been given authority. You are a king in the spirit, but yet you do not know it. Oh my God. A king commands. He doesn't ask. Oh my God. Do you see a king saying, can you please bring me cupbearer? Can you please bring me a drink of water? That's illustrated in the Bible when the guy comes, he says, "Listen, Jesus." He says, "I need you to heal my son." And Jesus answers him, and most people would have took Jesus' answer. He says, "I'll go with you." He says, "Listen, I'm not befit for you to even come see my house. For I am a man of authority, and I know when I tell one to go, he goes. When I tell another to do this, he does it. Only send the word, and I already know what happened." Jesus looks at him and says, "I've never seen such authority and faith in my life, in this whole entire realm. As you have requested, it is so." Oh my God, y'all better. Are y'all catching that?
Yes.
Somebody say, "I'm the head and not the tail."
I am the head and not the tail.
In Jesus' name, I am the head and not the tail.
In Jesus'
name, I am above and not beneath.
In Jesus'
name. In Jesus' name. Gentiles shall come to my light. And kings to my rising. Are you hearing me? See, listen, that's annoying right there. Gentiles will come to my light and kings to my rising, to my uprising. Are you hearing me? When men say there's not enough, there shall be enough. There should be more than enough in my house. Oh my God. Say, "The favor of the Lord is upon my life. I decree and I declare that no weapon formed against me shall prosper." Say,
I decree
that 1,000 shall fall by my side and 10,000 by my right hand, and it shall not come near me. Y'all better catch that. You say, "Apostle, how can I protect myself while I'm sleeping?" Send the word.
Yes.
"Touch not my anointed and do my prophets no harm." Y'all better catch.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Yes, God.
You saying in the, "Please, Jesus, don't let no demons attack me tonight. Cover me. And please, I don't want no wet dreams. And please."
Is it true?
Satan laughing at you. You have no authority. I just don't understand. It happened anyway. Do you ever see a commander say, "Hey, soldier, can you go over there and fight that war for me?" Listen, I've had it happen. I've had demons threaten me. You hear me? I've been praying for people and demons. Listen, I'm gonna come get you in your dreams. You hear me? I'm gonna come get you. I'm gonna get you now. I'm trying to pay you back for casting all my spirits out of. The next time I met with the spirit, you know what he said? I said, "I thought you said you was coming to get me." He said, "I asked my master, and my master said, you are untouchable. You cannot be touched him."
Wow.
Y'all better catch that.
Wow, yes, Lord.
I've had too many soldiers around me. You cannot touch him.
Yes, Lord. Yes, God.
I'm not bragging in my own power. I'm bragging in the, oh my God.
Yes.
So cool, Rimanataki. Now stand to your feet. Look at your neighbor and say, "You have power."
You have power.
Say, "None shall hurt me.
None shall hurt me.
With my eyes shall I behold.
With my eyes shall I behold.
And with my eyes only shall I behold the reward of the wicked." See, you got to send your command. Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
Oh my God, what are we going to do when Russia goes? With my eyes only shall I behold the reward of the wicked.
Yes.
It shall not come. Oh my God.
My God, yes,
Lord.
Yes, God.
Sure.
Yes. Yes, God.
My path is a shining light,
yes,
ever shining so bright. I am. Oh my God.
Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I know in whom I serve and believe, and I know he is faithful to keep me until the day he comes.
Yes.
Yes.
I've not had a demon touch me in my dream in probably 15, 20 years.
Wow.
Look at your neighbor and say, "I got a source behind me. I got a posse behind me. Oh my God." And so when he thinks he's going to come get me, my posse blocks it. Are you hearing me?
Yes,
hand of God.